But they do, okay? Most men, I'm not stereotyping, but most men, you might have a brown pair of shoes and a black pair of shoes, a pair to play in and a pair of work boots. My wife has, for some reason, 73 black shoes. Apparently, well, she's lost one. This is called, I like the name, the Shoe Go Round. Mm-hmm. It's a pinwheel pocket organizer, and you're getting two of them.
Yes.
And this thing, listen, size-wise, it's sizable. It's easily enough to hold a dozen pairs of shoes. You're getting two, so I did the math. That would be 24.
You got
you
it.
You weren't
going to
help me, were you?
Left no,
me
I was
going to
let you go.
You left me hanging.
I knew you could do it.
I want to welcome back Erica Swineford.
Hello.
Erica again, and I say this, she's just wonderful. She's a
Aww,
very, very busy
you.
Entrepreneur. She has six lovely children.
I do.
So if your life isn't organized at home, your head will explode.
Yeah, and you know what? That's a funny thing, Dan. I'm not an organized person by nature. If you ask my mom, she'll say, no way. She never was organized.
You need the tools, don't you?
But, right, yep. If I find things that work, then I stick with what works, and I have to have some kind of system. And this is great because it allows you to use that space, again, just like on the back of your door, there's space under our bed that's probably filled with cobwebs, dust bunnies.
Yep.
You might have shoes thrown under there. You might have all kinds of things thrown under there. This really allows you to organize and maximize that space under all the beds in your home, not just your bed, but your kids' beds, your guest bed, and you can put your shoes, organize them 12 pairs in one, and you're getting two, so 24 pairs of shoes.
And you can, by the way, look at the
and
top.
And then,
you
this is what
see.
I love. Right. So
you can see your shoes,
you see
but they don't
you
become
have.
Dust covered.
Right. So you're protecting them from dust, you're protecting them from pests, but you're also able to organize and see everything you have. So when I pull this out from under my bed, you get these reinforced handles, one on each side.
Nice.
It slides in and out easily from under your bed. You can see exactly what you have. So if you're storing all of your shoes in here, it's great for that. If you're storing your seasonal items, your off-seasonal items, it's great for that. You know, your winter shoes in the summer when you're not wearing those every day. I love it for that.
Just bear with me. It also, strangely enough, is the perfect size for Christmas ornaments.
It is.
From the Christmas tree.
We talk about that a lot, and
they're
stackable. So if you want to put Christmas, you know, decor in here, ornaments, and you want to put them up on a shelf in your basement or in your garage, you can stack them as well. But it's all about keeping things protected, organized, and being able to see.
Yeah.
And I like to show inside because I have larger, you know, clogs here. I have really high heels, you know, sneakers, flats. And because these little, I like to say they're little kind of pizza slices, they're flexible.
Yep.
So you can store, you know, the smaller pair of shoes next to the higher heels. Just about every pair of shoes is going to fit in here, with the exception of like your high boots. But you know, all of your normal shoes, day-to-day shoes and dress shoes are going to fit perfectly in here. And because it's only 5.5 inches tall, it's going to fit under just about every bed. I have a lower sleigh bed that has a lower profile. But again, because this is flexible, it's not a hard box. It's flexible. You can really slide it under and make the most of your
space. If you're not using it, you fold it up and you can store it.
Right.
I made a comment before. Most storage, like the plastic bins, are the same size empty as they are full.
Right. You have to store your storage.
And then you got to find, So I've got colors for you. I've got four different colors that are available. And don't let this beige color scare you. This easily wipes down with the plastic top if need be. Here's the beige.
Mm-hmm.
You are working with the navy blue.
Right.
Down in the front, I've got a brown, like a chocolate brown.
Right, really pretty brown.
And then I also have a beige,
or a gray. Yeah,
that's what I
have the gray. So if you want to get the color that kind of goes with your carpet the best, so it blends in, you can, or just pick your favorite. But we showed shoes, of course, and 24 pairs of shoes, because you get two in whatever color you get. But things like this, stuffed animals, Dan, for the kids, the toys, the Legos. You know, I like to store my bathing suits in here in the wintertime when I'm not using
them.
And we're soon going
to be in that transitional phase of fashion.
Absolutely. So, this is the time of year that you're kind of pulling from both wardrobes.
Dressers are like garages. You're never going to have enough,
enough
room. So, yeah, take some of those off-season clothing and roll them up. Rolling them up usually prevents wrinkling. And you've got a ton of space here.
You really do. And because of these flexible sides, again, I can put a larger handbag next to maybe my smaller kind of dressier holiday handbags and really fit just about everything in here. I have scarves and gloves, so this is perfect for your seasonal items. Again, where do you put all these, you know, when you're not using them, and then when you need them, you can't find them?
here was my problem, and it did become a problem. Again, I'm not an organizational expert by any stretch of the imagination. I, like you, I needed help. I needed somebody who knew what the heck they were doing to provide me with the tools to make it happen. But when you're dyslexic and you're also attention deficit, if you're not organized, your life spins out of control very quickly. And that was my youthful days. So we would have storage, but they were bottomless pits.
Right.
And we had this big bin that sat in our entryway, and that's where we would put gloves and scarves.
Right.
And if you threw them in there,
they never came out.
That's the thing, right?
So you wind up with one glove missing, and you hold on to the other one for 32 years.
Right.
It's just ridiculous. With this, you can see what you've got.
You can. And, you know, a lot of us store our shoes in those big bins. You know, when it,
if
our
you don't, they get
shoes,
dusty, they get dirty.
And what happens when they're in those huge bins is this happens. So all your shoes are kind of thrown in there, and they're scratching and scuffing and getting each other dirty. Well, the shoe go-round stores
them.
Right, but it separates them.
Because your high heels are too classy to talk to your tennis shoes.
Right, exactly.
So I know that.
We want to keep them apart. They fight if they get together.
Girls' shoes can be very snooty towards one another.
That's right. So keep them separate. But this is a great way to do it. 12 pairs of shoes, and just about every style of shoe we have in here, you know, again, with the exception of your really tall boots that you're going to store. But 12 pairs in each, and because you get two, it's 24 pairs of shoes. And not just your bed, but if you have a guest bed and you're not making the most of that space under there, you can use that as well as a storage system.
I think it's a really smart idea. I think it's a wonderful idea. And you, thank you for
your help. Hey, thanks for being here.
All that you do. We've got more. It's right now, just a few minutes after the bottom of the hour. We've got more to talk about in getting organized options. Here's one I love. It's such a simple idea. It truly was the very first item that I'd purchased at QVC from the experts to help me to get organized in my home. And it was simply coat hangers. Coat hangers. What? Well, when you've got